I mean, look, it's scary to hear it. I know you all are heroic to be, you know, working under those conditions. You know, what are the conditions of the patients who are coming into your ER right now? And are you, would you say, fully at this point at or over capacity?
From what I understand, almost all the ERs are over capacity. When I worked, and I don't work that often because I have presidential duties in the organization, my colleagues are working overtime and extra shifts to be able to just meet the need because we have so many people who are out sick. They're taking care of way too many patients at one time, and we have patients waiting for beds upstairs. They're cohorting COVID positive with presumptive COVIDs, which is not safe. People are waiting days for beds. We don't really have enough beds, and we were behind the eight ball to begin with, because over the past 10 or 20 years, we've lost 20,000 beds in New York State because of the Medicaid cuts and this kind of draconian attitude of just letting us function under bare bones. So we were ill-prepared to begin with, and now it's just total overload.
So the Washington Post reports tonight, I don't know if you saw this, but they're reporting that some hospitals are discussing a universal do not resuscitate policy for infected patients. They're talking about hospitals in Washington, D.C., hospitals in Chicago having conversations they never thought they would have to have. But that they're discussing this because of the danger to exposing doctors and nurses, that basically they wouldn't be able to do everything possible to resuscitate a person who may be dying because of the risk of infecting everybody caring for them and the great risk that carries. I mean, are those conversations also happening at your hospital?
I've heard whispers about that, but that's what's so outrageous. If we had the appropriate equipment, that wouldn't be an issue. If you look at what happened in China after the initial epidemic, where people didn't have the appropriate PPE, when they brought in 40,000 healthcare workers from across the country, they gave them those hazmat suits and all the appropriate PPE, and they had zero infection rate. Same thing happened in South Korea and also in Singapore. If we have the appropriate equipment, we can resuscitate people. We can do whatever it is that we need to do for people. This is inexcusable, and I hold the CDC and the federal government responsible. They're supposed to protect us. They're supposed to protect the public. Instead of responding the way that they should, they didn't prepare, and now who are the victims? The public's the victim, and the caregivers are the victims. It's outrageous.
Are the caregivers, are the nurses able to, you know, you talk about them being sick, and also, I mean, you know, we all know in Italy 10% of those infected are frontline healthcare workers. We see it in Spain. And these are people like you, nurses, doctors, who are literally putting their lives on the line. You know, when you see some of the people who are younger who are succumbing to this disease, many of them are healthcare workers, you know, who are exhausted and around so much of it. Are they able to get the nurses right now, if they're sick, access to tests? Get those tests back immediately? Are they able to get answers?
No, they're not. They relaxed the test. They had done some testing, then they increased testing, and now they pulled back on the testing. You have to be really sick to get a test right now. And the wait time, I had some symptoms. I had a test. They said 24 hours would come back. That was on a Thursday. I didn't get my results till a Monday. But they allowed me to go back to work on Sunday, not even knowing my test results, so because they relaxed the return to work rules. But the test results aren't coming back in time. And very sadly, we lost a nurse today, not in my hospital, in one of our sister facilities, who succumbed to the disease. That was our first nurse death that we know about. And we also have nurses who are ill. One of our own nurses in my hospital was in the ICU, is still in the ICU, I believe, on a ventilator from COVID-19.
Well, we are thinking of them and just the incredible heroism. I know everyone in this country, I hope, gets chills when you think about the people who are willing to go every day to work knowing that they could get sick or they could die, and they do it anyway, and they do it to save other people. Thank you so very much. I appreciate your time.
We want to get the appropriate equipment so we can help you. That's what we want.